Hello, this is Benjamin from Maya HTT. In this video, I will show you how to simulate a flat gasket in a finite element analysis using Simcenter 3D with a Nastran solution 402. The demonstration model is similar to the one used in the bolt preload tutorial linked below. This model consists in a flange tube with an end cap bolted at its end. A flat gasket is also present between the bolted components. I will show you how to mesh the gasket, how to define the gasket material, and how to assign the proper material orientation. Then I will apply bolt preloads and working loads. After solving the simulation, I will show you how to understand the gasket results. You can see in the FEM file the four bolts, the tube, the cap, and the gasket, which is squeezed between the tube and the cap. The first thing I do is to mesh the gasket using a 3D swept mesh. The gasket must have only one element through its thickness. To enforce that, I check use layers and type 1 as the layer quantity in the 3D swept mesh window. Then I edit the collector to specify which material to use. In the material list, I select a gasket material which I already defined. The gasket is defined with a matte G card. The first property on the card is a membrane material. The membrane material is a simple isotropic material that is used if the gasket is in tension. The other parameters define the properties of the gasket in compression in the thickness direction. The main properties are the loading and the unloading curves. You can see that the loading curve is elastic up to 2.1 kPa. This pressure must also be specified in the yield pressure box. After this pressure, the gasket will plastify. If the load is removed, the gasket strain will follow one of the unloading curves or an interpolation of two unloading curves. Now that the material is defined, I must also specify the material orientation. The solver requires the direction 1 or X of the material to be in the gasket thickness direction. To do so, I edit the mesh associated data of my swept mesh and I select the Y vector as the first direction of the material. I can quickly verify that the orientation is well defined using the material orientation check. I see that all the arrows point in the thickness direction. Since I already meshed the other components, I can now open my simulation file. In the simulation file, I create a solution 402. In the case control section, I edit the output request to obtain the gasket results. In the parameters, I enable the material nonlinearity. In this newly created solution, I add a fixed constraint at the base of the tube. Then, I define automatic surface-to-surface contact between every component. I then create two preload subcases and I drag and drop bolt preloads that were already created in those subcases. In the first subcase, all the bolt preloads are equal. In the second subcase, one of the bolts has a higher preload than the others. If you wish to see how I define the bolt preloads, you can look at this tutorial video. I then create a static subcase where I define a pressure in the internal faces of the tube and the cap. The solution is now complete. I can solve it and look at the results. The results are loaded. On the left, the gasket pressure is plotted, and on the right, the gasket status is displayed. The gasket status provides an integer for each element that gives the information whether the gasket is sealed or open, and if there is or not plastic deformation. The gasket's loading and unloading curves are also shown to help understand the gasket results. I will look at the result at the two locations shown with arrows, and I will show the pressure and strain state of those locations in the graph below. In the first subcase, the preload is equal in the four bolts, and the gasket pressure is below the yield pressure everywhere. Therefore, the status is sealed without plastic deformation. In the second subcase, the preload is increased in the bottom right bolt. Therefore, there is more pressure near this bolt and there is plastic deformation in the green area. The gasket status is now sealed with plastic deformation in this area. When the working load is applied, the gasket pressure reduces and the gasket strain is reduced following the elastic loading curve for the purple area and following the unloading curve for the green area. As long as the pressure is greater than 1% of the yield pressure, the gasket is still considered to be sealed in both locations. When the working load gets higher, the purple area reaches a pressure of 0 kPa and the gasket becomes open without plastic deformation since the strain is 0. Then the green area reaches 0 pressure and the gasket becomes open with residual plastic deformation since there is residual strain in this area. Finally, as the pressure increases, the gasket becomes open almost everywhere and the cap is not sealed anymore. This is how you define and post-process a flat gasket in a solution 402. Thank you for watching.